Good defence there by St John, stopping the ball getting out to the wing. Bit of footwork there and speed too. Oh, I said they were pretty good. Number two, Hamiso Tabuai from the Australian Youth Sevens team. And look at that. What skill. Under the posts, 5-0.
Yeah, lovely turn of foot there, Peter. And we raced away and scored that easily in the end.
Conversion successful. It's 7 points to nil. Number of these Lloyd McDermott boys are in the Scots college teams, actually. Three of them, Lockie Crossley, Leon Wanungmara, and Randall Yongbulla in the Scots college second 15. Now St John's. Nice is the ball. The defence is there. Good pass back inside. St John's playing much better than they did in the first match. Connor Rogers tackle 30 metres out. Nice stepping, but a good ball and all tackle by David Williams from the Lloyd McDermott team. Ball and all, that's the way to tackle them in sevens. Ball stolen by Lloyd McDermott. Now they've got the chance to attack. Look out for this fellow on the left wing. We saw what he can do. On the outside break this time. Just eases past the defence and goes in for his second try.
Yeah, he certainly showed a clean pair of heels there to run away for his second try. So Lloyd McDermott out to 12, but the kick to come over St John's yet to score.
Hamiso Tabuai showed the step and the fend and the speed in the first try. That time, the in and away, swerve and acceleration, all the skills. Once again, that number 10, David Williams, he's so strong in the upper body, he's able to wrap people up, hold up the ball, but they've managed to recycle it. So here goes St John's on the attack again. Three men on two if they can use the ball. But good defence. Now the chance. One to beat. Oh, what a flick pass. Sensational stuff by St John's. Well, the ball was out, the referee said, so that's a fair play. And still it comes back to St John's. Harry Wright. He did the flick pass before, but it doesn't come off every time. It's a bit of a risky play. Loses that one. Feature of this McDermott team, they all tackle so strongly, don't they?
Yeah, we saw some the ball and all tackles have been sensational, and also a great cover tackle there from Leon earlier on here. So very good in defence. And you're right with what you're saying, it makes a hell of a difference if you can really wrap the ball up and not get the second phase play. It's a great advantage.
So here goes the Lloyd McDermott team, sensibly just knocked on with the boot, so no knock on. And the ball kicked across field, unusually, into touch. So there'll be the Farrow Memorial Agricultural High School ball. They've been hanging on to possession quite well, but unable to penetrate. Love to see him score. Well, there's a change of tactics.
Yeah, hanging on there, not releasing the ball.
Leon Munangbara. So here's the numbers, if they can use the ball here. But defence converging. St John's have managed to recycle it. Little halfback goes darting through. That's Connor Rogers. On the inside run is Tom Gowan. Oh, the ball stolen out of his hands by the Lloyd McDermott team. And here's a run straight down the centre of the field. It's going to be another easy try. Number two for Lloyd McDermott. That's try number three for Hamiso Tabuai.
Remember, if you've lost your gold iPhone, please come up to the commentator's box. A gold iPhone has been handed in.
Conversion successful, 21 points to nil at halftime.
Yeah, St John's had plenty of ball in that half, Peter. I was surprised that they couldn't get across the line, but I suppose that's credit to the Lloyd McDermott's defence. So, obviously the good defence was speaking about earlier, paying off the Lloyd McDermott. Opportunity to bounce back and have a score a few tries.
All credit to St. John. I think they've improved a lot since their first game. And they're keeping the ball alive, but they're just not making the breaks. And even when they do, this Lloyd McDermott team's got such pace.
They do, and they're a very hard side to play because you don't know what they're going to do. They're a very expansive style traditionally in sevens and very creative, and so you're not sure exactly what it's very hard to defend when you're not 100% what the opposition is going to do.
There was an article in the paper this morning about the problem with Australian rugby is that we're too structured. It started sort of back in the early 2000s when it worked. But everyone else is playing unstructured football now. And I think there's no better way of learning unstructured rugby than sevens.
Yeah, well, that's right. I mean, it's great to see that the boys are being expansive, and I think we're going to see it also from the Fijians later on today as well from what we saw in their first game.
You know, so many Wallabies and All Blacks have come through the sevens program. You see them first displaying their skills in the sevens game, and then they go on. We've received a gift from the organisers, hot dogs for the commentators. Very nice, thank you. Here's the restart, second half. 21 points to nil to the Lloyd McDermott team. Ooh, attempted high tackle there. Got away with it. Now St John's whipping the ball across. Harry Wright. Unfortunately, the hands let them down.
If you've parked your Land Rover with a number plate of CNB68U, could you please go to the car? Because it's actually parked someone in. So that's a Range Rover, a Land Rover, CNB68U. Could you please go to your car immediately?
Lloyd McDermott's with the ball. Good defence by Wright. Once again, Wright makes another tackle. But still Lloyd McDermott on the attack. David Williams. Good pass. Gave his man the chance. If he's strong enough, and he is, he's big and strong, and he's over in the corner. That's Lionel Sadler.
Yeah, great show of strength there, and it's a lovely right to left passing. I think in schoolboy level, often you see when they're going from right to left, the passes are generally a lot crisper than they are when going left to the other way around. So keep an eye on that for the attacking ability. Right to left is always crisp passes.
Full marks to St John's for I'm getting confused. In their defence, they're certainly not giving up. They're trying, but they're just being out-muscled by some of these big, strong boys from the Lloyd McDermott team. Points to nil. Good restart. Nicely taken. St John's from Nambour, but they've turned it over and quickly snapped out to the left. And it's going to be an easy run around number two. I don't think that's Tabawai, I beg your pardon. But it's a try to the Lloyd McDermott team. The easiest of tries.
Well, the Lloyd McDermott side really showing there's no substitute for speed out here today.
Yeah, that try was number four. That's Tico Twist who scored the try for the Lloyd McDermott team. So 21 points to nil. Yeah, I think the score should be 26 nil because it was 21 nil at half time. Thanks, boys. Now St John's. Tom Gowan, two Gowan brothers in this team. And the turnover. Lloyd McDermott looking for the gap, and a little show and go there. Still, he hasn't got to the line, but he's got support who will get to the line.
Yeah, it was a lovely offload there from Lloyd McDermott. Set up a sensational try.
An unselfish play, unloaded as the support came. 31 points to nil with a kick to come right in front. That was number one, Byron Nara. National Indigenous 7's team. 33-0.
Scores actually 33-0 to Lloyd McDermott here. 33 points to nil over St John's.
This is Jackson going. Jackson Porters. But the ball on the ground is snapped up by Lloyd McDermott. And quickly out to the wing where this fella's got lots of pace. That's Tabawai. And he loves to use that little swerve and his tremendous pace. And he goes over for his fourth try.
Yeah, lovely balance runner, Peter. Really lovely balance with the ball in hand. And too quick. And as we said, there's no substitute for speed in 7's.
Yeah, he's a go-to man, that's for sure. The left wing, they just get it to him and away he goes. It's like having Usain Bolt in your back line. There's a conversion, successful. Makes it 40. 40 points to nil. Good restart. High ball. Difficult one for Jackson Cohen, but he took it well. Jackson Porters just standing and delivering as the half-time, I beg your pardon, full-time, 40 points to nil.
As his son comes down gloriously here at